The North-South Commuter Railway's Clark to Valenzuela segment set to be up and running in the first quarter of 2028. Well, the Manila to Calamba Laguna section of the mega railway project, meanwhile, is expected to start operations a year later. Andre Taguines walks us through the latest developments and timeline for this major infrastructure project. Take a look.
The Clark to Valenzuela segment of the North-South Commuter Railway is set to open in the first quarter of 2028. This infrastructure is seen to cut the travel time between the Clark International Airport in Pampanga and West Valenzuela to less than an hour. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista led the inspection of the Balagtas Station in Bulacan and Malanday Depot on Thursday, and he said almost all right-of-way issues from Malolos to Valenzuela have been resolved. Undersecretary Jeremy Rijino said the agency is now concentrating on what he described as the critical path.
Our problems are in the Angeles, Apalit, going to San Fernando area, and also Kalumpit. We are concentrating on the right-of-way acquisition. We will be able to hand over possession to the contractor by this year.
The DOTR earlier announced that partial operations of the North-South Commuter Railway from Clark to Valenzuela would happen by 2027. And while that could still be possible under a best-case scenario, the DOTR also has utility relocation issues to address on top of right-of-way acquisition.
We need to fix first the relocation site and then transfer these power and water lines. Otherwise, large communities will be affected, even those outside the right-of-way of PNR. Kasi hindi naman pwedeng putulin na lang namin yung kuryente.
Meanwhile, the Manila to Calamba Laguna portion of the railway project is expected to operate by 2029. That's as the DOTR faces more challenging right-of-way problems in these areas.
Natanaw tayo sa Buendia, sa EDSA, so medyo this, and then we will have to relocate 13,000 informal settlers from Manila to Calamba. Oh, these are the areas actually of concern that will either delay or hasten the completion of the project.
These are all part and parcel of the 147-kilometer North-South Commuter Railway, which will run from New Clark City in Tarlac to Calamba, Laguna. It will have 58 train sets, 7 of which will be used as airport express trains from Clark International Airport to the Ninoy Aquino International Airport in Pasay. The Transportation Department has yet to come out with the fare matrix, but Bautista gave this assurance to commuters.
One of the objectives or desire of the Department of Transportation is to have affordable travel experience for our passengers. No? So we see to it that this will be affordable. This will be at least at par with the fares of buses and jeepneys. No?
The project will also be employing around 10,000 personnel to be trained by the Philippine Rail Institute. Andrea Taguines, ABS-CBN News.
The Makati City government launches a revamped domestic tourism campaign to encourage more local tourists to visit the commercial district and its heritage sites. Under the Visit a Better Makati program, the city's sister cities and municipalities would enjoy up to 60% discount vouchers that could be redeemed at selected partner merchants. Also, in the program, you have free walking tours available, including areas around the Central Business District, the Poblacion Heritage Sites, and the famous Salcedo Market and Legazpi Market. A real estate consultant is seeing the Philippine office space segment recovering to pre-COVID levels in the 2 to 3 years' time. The Lobien Realty Group cites the rise of the outsourcing industry for the growth, saying this will help offset the impact from any government ban on offshore gaming operations or POGOs in the country. Senators and business groups have recently urged the Marcos government to ban POGOs due to their ties to crimes and human rights violations.
Not back to the pre-pandemic, at least for the office market. In the residential, when you look at the retail market, the warehouse, it's better than the pre-pandemic levels, but office market slowly recovering because, like what Ron mentioned, the hybrid work, the work from home, that setup affected the take-up in the office market. 2 to 3 years from now, that's how we look at it, because the supply is also, the developers are not building more. When you look at the supply in the next 3 years, it was cut by half. Mm-hmm. And that's, I think, that's how the market reacts. So the market is correcting, less supply because the demand is not that high. Mm-hmm. But the good news is the growing outsourcing industry, their projection is that in 2028, in the next 4 years, they'll double the headcount. Mm. And, just get half of that, because not everyone will be working from the office.
Now, the Gokongwei-owned digital bank, GoTime, eyeing expansion overseas, and it aims to add over a million more Filipino customers in the second half of the year. We have more from Jackie Pascual.
Digital bank GoTime is optimistic of hitting over 5 million customers by the end of the year. GoTime, a collaboration of the Gokongwei Group and Time Group, says the first half of the year added 1.7 million users, bringing to 3.7 million the current number of customers. Its CEO Nate Clark asserts with their growth trajectory, profitability is near.
We're gunning for a break even by the end of next year. And then our first year of full profitability would be then 2026.
Its shareholders recently acquired the country's largest fintech salary lender, Savvy, which will boost GoTime's portfolio.
That brings two big opportunities, lending. So it'll accelerate our lending growth. So they already have a 3 billion pesos payroll lending book. But I think even maybe more importantly, they have access to over 500,000 employees.
The bank is also now eyeing overseas expansion. It announces that Filipinos in over 100 countries can now open an account using a foreign SIM.
Mapa-Italy ka, mapa-US ka, itong SIMs na to pwedeng, it's going to be easier for them to move money to their relatives here in the Philippines.
GoTime will also soon allow checks to be deposited by just using the app. Users just need to take a photo of the check, even post-dated checks, any time of the day. It also partnered with a central bank to deposit coins at coin deposit machines and credit it directly to the GoTime account. More billers were also added to the app.
With the addition of MMDA for your traffic violations, very convenient, PSA Serbilis, and Asian Vision Cable Holdings, among others. Loading your toll cards when you have a spontaneous out-of-town trip.
GoTime plans to become the number one bank in terms of customer experience as it eyes to make banking, in their own words, beautiful. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
From banking to agri, Philippine Agri Chief Francisco Tularel Jr. looking at a one-year trial for government's 29 peso per kilo rice program, dubbed Bigas 29. The program targets vulnerable sectors, including indigents, senior citizens, and persons with disabilities, among others, covering an estimated 34 million Filipinos. It was launched earlier this month. The trial involves currently 10 Kadiwa centers in Metro Manila and Bulacan operating on weekends. Laurel said the program will be expanded to cover areas outside Luzon by August or September, and ideally to all 1,500 municipalities all over the country. He emphasized the need for an extended trial to assess the entire supply chain, identifying cost-saving measures to sustain low consumer prices. The DA chief also believes prices of rice could further drop with anticipated increases in production from countries like Vietnam and Thailand and the potential lifting of India's export ban.